in my feelings, in my mind, Bach is so much alive that I feel very comfortable to talk about him like about a person that lives right now, that works, has a family, writes music, makes something for himself. And if you would look through all his works, you will see some works that done just as a job. And many of them, how we know, he left in the church because it was just done for a Sunday service. But the pieces that are so much played today, like Brandenburg concertos, like Bach solo sonatas, pieces that are so wonderful, but were not done for a service, were forgotten for 200 years. I think that many of the composers that play in self-importance, they create for themselves an image that even their music is not so great, but for some reason it's more played than Bach was played for these 200 years, that he was actually not played, he was forgotten. I think that style, it's not more than appearance. And if you would ask a small child that lost his mom in the early age what he remembers about her, he will tell you, I remember my mom, she wear red shoes. But the mom is not about shoes, it's about big spirit that somebody has inside. And when we are talking about a composer, it doesn't matter if it's Bach or Vivaldi or Mozart, we should talk about music, about personality, about maybe biography, but never about style separately. That means for me just appearance or something that can be added to music, but not something that should be a major thing for creating a piece. In my opinion, a lot of composers created their image, putting their signature in the end of the piece. And many of them create their image being very precise in the end of the piece. The signature is, I am Tchaikovsky, I am Beethoven, I am Mozart, I am Haydn. All music by Bach doesn't have this last signature. And maybe it's sad enough or funny enough to tell that maybe the music was forgotten because it didn't have the self-important signature in the end. Bach, I am Bach. It was just music that you should love and you should feel and you should play. If we will look through the A minor fugue or C major fugue or G minor fugue, and if we will go back to our conversation about the beginning of the fugue with the right hand, the playing the fugue with the image of an organ player, you have a feeling of a big, big structure, that a big building that Bach is building from beginning to the very end. And here, when he comes to the very end, here you need the signature that will tell you, this is my creation, and I am so important, and I am so big, and I am so huge, and here I am, B-A-C-H. Just a short part, the ending, just the ending of the A minor fugue, that it's so well constructed, it's so big, and the very end that you would expect that the composer goes to the very end finally to put his signature and to show how important he is because he created something like this fugue. And what Bach does, he goes to the very end and instead to make us feel that we are so small and he is so big. He lightens to the very end everything, and the A minor he turns in 1 second to A major, and he gives us hope. This is the hope that we will see this man again, and he just tells you goodbye. Thank you.